When you think of Emma Smith, do you think of a pioneer lady in a long dress with dark hair and ringlets? The one that was the wife of the Prophet Joseph Smith, the first Relief Society president, and the editor of the first hymn book? While these are true, there may be some things about Emma that you don't know. Over the past 10 years, I've had the privilege of deeply studying her life. Even though she lived two centuries ago, there is much we can learn from her to help us navigate our challenging times today. I would like to share with you five lessons for our day that I have learned from this select lady, Emma Smith. I am Jenny Reeder, and this is my 5-Minute Fireside. Emma was determined to do something extraordinary. In the 21st century, we can learn from her how to turn the ordinary into something extraordinary. The first lesson I learned from Emma is that while our plans may be derailed, if we keep picking ourselves up and pressing forward, we will eventually accomplish the extraordinary. Sometimes things don't work out exactly as we planned or hoped. This happened to Emma Smith all the time. She received a revelation from the Lord in 1830, telling her that she was an elect lady and that she would compile the first hymn book for the new church. Well, that hymn book took 6 years to put together, and the organization of Relief Society took another 6 years. Things kept getting in the way, like moving from Pennsylvania to New York to Ohio to Missouri to Illinois. Or the printing press was destroyed by a mob. Like Emma, we can learn to be patient, to start over again if needed, and to use the resources we have. In time, we can do something extraordinary. Lesson two from Emma. Take time for self-care. Our homes sometimes feel like they have revolving doors. There's always someone coming or going, errands to run, messes to clean up. We need to take time for ourselves. And we need to renew relationships one-on-one. Emma did that by going horseback riding with Joseph for private conversation. She was an excellent horsewoman. Her brothers taught her how to ride when she was young, and she loved it. As an adult, she found freedom and joy in riding like the wind or going slow to have deep discussions with her husband. Maybe you don't have access to a horse to ride, but what is it that you do love to do? Take time to renew so that you can do something extraordinary. Lesson three from Emma was to not be afraid to use our voices. Emma did not like the way Joseph was being treated, living under the constant threat of being extradited to Missouri for a crime he never committed. She gathered the Relief Society women to sign a petition for the governor. Then she personally delivered it. She and the governor exchanged a few letters where she very aptly drew upon the U.S. Constitution, the Constitution of the State of Illinois, and the City Charter of Nauvoo. We too have the responsibility to speak up against injustice. The church has a new initiative encouraging women to run for political office. How can you, like Emma, use your voice and become involved in politics and in your community? The fourth lesson I learned from Emma was to teach and cheer one another on. Emma was the first president of the Relief Society, where she both expounded scripture and exhorted the church. Do you really know what those words mean? To expound means to teach or preach, to explain the meaning. To exhort means to cheer, encourage, or embolden someone. How can you expound truth and exhort your family, your neighbors, your coworkers, and your Relief Society sisters? The fifth and final lesson I took from my time studying Emma was to not be afraid to get dirty. Emma walked through a lot of mud and crossed a lot of frozen rivers. Can you imagine wearing a long dress in the dust and mud? Sometimes we just need to get down on the floor with the kids or out in the dirt with the neighbors. Sometimes we overthink our appearance, that we just aren't good enough, that we don't have the right hair or teeth or clothes, or we feel insecure about our bodies or our ability to entertain perfectly. Maybe those things don't matter as much as just getting involved and connecting with someone on a close level, eye to eye or hand to hand. There's nothing that a shower or a vacuum or a hose can't fix. How can we not be afraid to get out and get around and truly care for each other? At the end of her life, Emma told her adult sons that she was an active participant in the restoration. and that the things she saw and experienced, from the gold plates to the finally completed hymn book to her sisters in Relief Society, were, in her words, indeed a marvel and a wonder. We too are active participants of the continuing restoration. And even in small ways, with patience and practice, with care and understanding, we too can do something extraordinary. I'm Jenny Reeder, and this has been my 5-Minute Fireside.